Hey there, Bee here. It's a beautiful day today, so I'm just getting ready to go out for a hike, and I... Uh-oh. Did you hear that? Maybe it's not a good day for a hike after all. Weather is a constant in our daily lives. The good, the bad, and the... noisy. But have you ever wondered what causes a powerful thunderstorm or a gentle flurry of snow? And what makes the weather change all the time? We're going to find out. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to explain the factors that influence weather patterns, relate weather to types of clouds, and explain how severe weather events occur. So have your guided notes ready, and let's get started. Let's start by talking about what weather really is. Weather is the state of the atmosphere at a certain place and at a certain time. We experience weather every day, and as we know, it can change from moment to moment. There are several key factors that influence weather patterns. These factors interact with each other to create the unique weather conditions that we experience each day. Let's start with humidity. Humidity is a measure of the amount of water vapor in the air. Humidity is connected to temperature, which is a measure of the warmth or coolness of the air, because warm air can hold more water vapor than cool air. As we learned in a previous lesson, warmer air rises and cooler air sinks. This causes air to move around, which creates wind. This wind can influence the formation of weather patterns by carrying warm and cool air from one place to another. For example, wind can move warm, humid air around, which can cause rain clouds to form. Now let's take a look at some of the weather patterns humidity, temperature, and wind can cause. When the weather is changing, one of the first things you'll probably notice is the clouds starting to look different. There are many different kinds of clouds, and each is linked to different kinds of weather. Let's start with cirrus clouds. These are wispy-looking clouds found very high in the atmosphere. Cirrus clouds are formed when large air masses of different temperatures move around, which pushes low-humidity air upwards. This causes the little bit of moisture in that air to freeze into wispy ice crystals, which we see as cirrus clouds. We usually see these types of clouds during clear weather, but they can often mean that the weather will be changing in a day or two since so much air is moving around. If you've ever looked up at the clouds on a sunny day and spotted interesting shapes in them, you were probably looking at cumulus clouds. These clouds form when humid air rises and cools, causing water vapor to condense vertically into droplets. This creates tall, puffy clouds. Cumulus clouds don't typically get big enough to contain a ton of water droplets that can fall as rain, so cumulus clouds tend to mean the weather will be clear. But sometimes factors like warm temperatures, high levels of humidity, and lots of wind causes these clouds to keep gathering more and more water vapor. Eventually, they can become cumulonimbus clouds, which are extremely tall anvil-shaped clouds. What kind of weather do you think these clouds bring? Pause the video here and record your thoughts in your guided notes. The gray color of these clouds might have tipped you off that they mean rain, snow, or hail, but that's not the only weather they bring. Cumulonimbus clouds are also the only clouds that produce lightning. Because these clouds gather so much extra water vapor, they are enormous and have a ton of energy stored in them, so they produce pretty severe weather. But what about not so severe rain showers? These come from stratus clouds. Stratus comes from the Latin word for layer, and that's how these clouds look, like a low, gray layer laid across the whole sky. Stratus clouds form when humid air is lifted up and cooled by gentle breezes. The water vapor in the air then condenses horizontally into a blanket of clouds. If it's kind of dreary out and it's been raining or snowing for hours, you're probably dealing with a stratus cloud. However, weather can also get much more intense than what these basic cloud formations can bring. Severe weather is the general term for intense, dangerous weather patterns. There are several different kinds of severe weather, but we're going to focus on three of the most intense and incredible: blizzards, hurricanes, and tornadoes. Blizzards are a type of severe weather that combines huge amounts of falling snow with strong winds. Blizzards can even cause whiteout conditions, which occur when the snow is so thick and has covered so much that there's no visible horizon, sky, or ground. It's all just snow. When blizzards come from cumulonimbus clouds, they can also occur with thunder and lightning. But a stratus cloud combined with some powerful wind from moving air masses can also lead to a blizzard. And since blizzards form in cold temperatures, they're basically the opposite of our next type of severe weather: hurricanes. A hurricane is a large storm made of rotating bands of clouds. Hurricanes bring very strong wind and heavy rain that can push ocean water onto land, causing massive flooding. So with these characteristics in mind, what kind of cloud do you think a hurricane is made of? Pause the video here and record your thoughts in your guided notes. Hurricanes are basically made up of enormous groups of cumulonimbus clouds. But what makes them get so huge? Hurricanes form in basically the same way as any cumulonimbus cloud. Hot, humid air rises and cools into a cloud. Except hurricanes tend to form over warm ocean water in the tropics, where there is tons of hot, humid air. These storms basically have an unlimited energy source, so they keep growing and growing until they move over land and let all that energy loose. Strong, spiraling winds aren't unique to hurricanes, though. Tornadoes are swirling funnels of wind that reach from the clouds to the ground, and they can be devastating. The most powerful hurricanes record wind speeds of a bit over 150 miles per hour, and tornadoes can nearly double that, with winds approaching 300 miles per hour. On the bright side, while hurricanes can last weeks, tornadoes usually only last a few minutes. Tornadoes start in cumulonimbus clouds, when rising hot air and falling cool air start to create a spinning air current inside the cloud. The falling cool air pushes this spinning air down lower and lower until it eventually reaches the ground and starts moving. Severe weather is part of what makes the job of meteorologists or weather scientists so important. They can help us predict and prepare for many kinds of severe weather. They're constantly monitoring global patterns of temperature, humidity, winds, and more to predict what weather is coming next, which means their work isn't just helpful. It is quite literally a lifesaver. Now let's review what we've learned today. Now, you know that factors like temperature, humidity, and wind all influence weather patterns, that different kinds of clouds all form in different ways and are each connected to different weather patterns, and that these conditions sometimes lead to severe weather, but meteorologists help us predict and prepare for these storms. Be sure to check out the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to learn even more about meteorology. And remember, in earth science, as in life, you rock! See you next time!